Hi, it's Katrina. From shy pythons to secretive water snakes, here are 10 snakes that are actually friendly. Number 10, ball pythons. The ball python, also called the royal python, is native to West and Central Africa. This widely distributed snake is a constrictor and is the smallest of the African pythons, reaching a maximum length of 6 feet, which is still pretty darn big. The ball python gets its name from its tendency to curl into a ball and hide its head when it's stressed or scared. Despite the species' somewhat timid and evasive nature, it's probably still easy to think that one could easily squeeze an average human to death. This isn't the case, however. Ball pythons are widely favored as pets, partially because they aren't typically big or strong enough to constrict an adult human, and the risk of injury from one is very minimal. They are among the most popular kinds of pet snakes because they are quite calm and docile. But of course, going near a ball python in the wild and/or owning one as a pet do come with some risks. For instance, while a specimen can't technically constrict a person to death, it is possible for one of these snakes to harm a human, especially a young child. And while a bite is unlikely to cause serious injury, the experience can still be traumatizing, painful, and expensive. For these reasons, ball pythons are best left to educated and responsible pet owners. In other words, do your research and do your part to reduce the amount of snakes poached from the wild. Know what you're getting yourself into, and be committed to providing the animal with top-notch care and respect its need for space. That pretty much goes for any pet. It's also a good idea to get a ball python when they're young so that you can properly train and socialize them. Number 9. Western Hognose Snake. The Western Hognose Snake is endemic to North America, occurring from southern Canada throughout the United States and down to northern Mexico. Though mildly venomous, this stout-bodied snake is harmless to humans. Its appearance varies depending on subspecies, with many Western Hognose Snakes resembling rattlesnakes in color and pattern. They are also called blow snakes, bluffer, faux viper, etc., because they pretend to be a dangerous, scary snake without biting, if possible. If it feels threatened, it will lie perfectly still, but if it can't avoid a predator, it will throw a hissy fit. It will puff its neck like a cobra and hiss very loudly. It will become hostile if necessary and take a couple of mock strikes, but not really. This snake is very dramatic. If that still doesn't work, it will pretend to drop dead and emit a foul odor and will stay limp even if you pick it up. Usually nobody wants to eat a rotting carcass, right? But one of these rear-fanged specimens certainly can't and won't do the same damage as a rattlesnake, say. While its venom is mostly harmful to toads, its preferred food source, it's extremely rare for the Western Hognose to bite people. In fact, there are no recorded deaths or allergic reactions from Hognose bites, and experts consider them medically inconsequential to humans. It's naturally very docile, and it's highly unlikely for one to attack a person in the first place. Number 8. Rosy Boa. Rosy boas are slow-moving, thick-bodied nocturnal snakes found in deserts, scrublands, and rocky mountainsides throughout the American Southwest and parts of Mexico, including the state of Baja California. During the day, they take refuge underneath rocks, and they spend their evenings and nights out hunting for prey. Young specimens eat mice and small snakes, graduating to larger food sources as they progress toward adulthood. And rosy boas in general are voracious eaters with eager appetites. Females are larger than males, with the species ranging in length from 2 to 4 feet. These snakes have one of the longest lifespans of all boas. They live over 20 years on average, with many surviving into their 30s. Rosy boas are not the friendliest looking creatures, but they are a popular pet, known for their ease of handling and good temperament. When one gets aggressive, it's usually due to lack of food rather than its natural demeanor, or something might be wrong with it. But even the most docile animals have a limit and will act defensively when they feel threatened or overhandled. So to avoid triggering an unwanted response, pet guardians are urged to limit handling time and to avoid holding their snake too tightly or limiting its movement. It can get annoyed. Number 7. Green Tree Python. First described in 1872 by German herpetologist Hermann Schlegel, the vividly hued green tree python is native to New Guinea, parts of Indonesia, and Australia's Cape York Peninsula, where it lives primarily in trees and hunts small mammals and reptiles. It grows up to 6.6 feet long and typically weighs around 3.5 pounds, with exceptionally large specimens tipping the scales at up to 5 pounds. The species certainly carries an intimidating look based on its alarmingly bright color and long body, and is also easily agitated and known to bite when provoked. They have a reputation for being aggressive, which is probably good for them. Males are especially likely to become aggressive during mating season while searching for a mate, and females are most inclined to act hostile when they have eggs to protect. But the green tree python is non-venomous, and while experts strongly recommend seeking medical treatment for bites and avoiding one in the first place, these snakes do not typically cause serious damage. These guys are not great for beginners, but some people describe their pythons as puppy dog friendly, super tame, and as sweethearts, as long as you don't catch them by surprise. However, they are very delicate and should be handled with care as they can be easily injured. They also have very specific needs if you are going to keep one as a pet, so be careful or they can die. This species has more reasons to fear us than the other way around. Despite its label of least concern on the International Union for Conservation of Nature Red List, the species' numbers are potentially threatened due to its popularity as a pet, which has resulted in rampant smuggling of wild-caught specimens, especially in Indonesia. Number 6. Garter snake. Garter snakes, which are often mistakenly referred to as garden snakes due to the similarity between the names, are one of the most common snakes throughout North America, with around 30 species being found from Canada all the way down to Florida. They are most easily identified by a line along their spine, and most have three longitudinal strips, a center one along their spine and one on each lower side of their body. Generally speaking, garter snakes are relatively small, ranging in length from 23 to 30 inches, but some species grow up to 5 feet long. It might be pretty scary to encounter one of these surprisingly common snakes, regardless of its size, especially if you're not expecting it and one comes slithering out of nowhere. But garter snakes are non-venomous, and in most cases, completely harmless to humans. When provoked, they may defend themselves by striking, just like any animal that feels cornered, but it's practically unheard of for this to result in serious injury. At worst, a bite victim can probably expect a scratch and some light bleeding. You can easily avoid a bite simply by not going near a garter snake, and by giving one its space if you unintentionally get too close. Number 5. Boa constrictor. Boa constrictors are known for their size and thickness, with those on the larger end of the spectrum reaching up to 13 feet long and weighing as much as 60 pounds. In the wild, they are found in various habitats in tropical North, Central, and South America, as well as parts of the Caribbean. These heavy-bodied, semi-aquatic solitary snakes are also popular as pets and are commonly kept and bred in captivity. Many people even allow boa constrictors to freely move about their home. I'm by no means saying that you should, I'm just saying that people do. Some people even have these snakes as emotional support animals. Of course, there are dangers to coming within close proximity of one, including the species' propensity for aggression and its ability to tightly coil around someone, potentially cutting off their air supply and suffocating them, or if you have a child around or other pets. They're even more likely to become aggressive while molting, due to a substance secreted from their eyes which obstructs their vision and interferes with their other senses. On the other hand, boa constrictors do not bite very often, although it's not out of the realm of possibility, especially if one gets spooked, but the good news is that they are non-venomous. Bites are typically not life-threatening, but victims are still urged to seek medical attention to avoid an infection, which could cause serious internal damage. The moral of the story? Use common sense when it comes to keeping a boa constrictor as a pet, and try not to encounter one in the wild unless you know what you're doing. Number 4. Corn snakes. As you've probably noticed by now, some snakes have passive demeanors while others might be aggressive but aren't dangerous. The corn snake is actually beneficial to humans, in addition to simply being harmless. A North American species, the corn snake is often recommended as a pet. Found throughout the central and southeastern US, this moderately sized snake kills its prey, usually rodents, by constriction. Outwardly, the corn snake somewhat resembles the venomous copperhead, sometimes unintentionally misleading people who will freak out and kill it. This is unfortunate because corn snakes, which are frequently sighted near grain stores, feed on mice and rats, thereby preventing the rodents from eating harvested crops. They act as natural pest control and, hey, it's cheaper than an exterminator. Besides being beneficial to farmers, corn snakes are non-venomous, reluctant to bite, and naturally docile, perhaps making them the most desirable snake for beginners. Number 3. California king snake. The California king snake is endemic to the western United States and northern Mexico, where it occurs in a variety of habitats, including woodland, grassland, deserts, marshes, high altitudes of up to 7,000 feet, and in the suburbs. These relatively small snakes, which rarely exceed 4 feet long, are active during the day but become nocturnal in hot weather and retreat into a hibernation-like state called brumation, which is where growth, development, and physical activity are temporarily halted. When they are not in brumation, they are active hunters and opportunistic feeders who kill rodents, birds, other reptiles, and amphibians via constriction. In other words, as you know, squeezing them to death. In fact, the California king snake has one of the strongest squeezes in ratio to its body size out of all snakes. This may be an evolutionary adaptation to its tendency to kill reptiles, who need less oxygen than mammals and therefore are more difficult to suffocate to death. They respond to disturbances and threats by coiling their bodies and hiding their heads, hissing and rattling their tails, which makes a sound similar to a rattlesnake. California king snakes are completely non-venomous, and they are prone to anxiety, but are typically more docile than most other snakes their size, and only tend to become aggressive when agitated, making them ideal pets. And when raised in captivity, they usually turn out very calm. Number 2. Milk snakes. Found throughout North and South America, milk snakes are a king snake species which bear a somewhat striking resemblance to venomous copperhead and coral snakes, and are often mistaken for them due to their bright, blotchy coloration. Altogether, there are 24 recognized milk snake subspecies, ranging in length from 14 to 69 inches, and some scientists believe some actually constitute their own species. Milk snakes are well known for their use of mimicry as a defensive strategy, herpetologist Bill Hayborn told Life Science, also noting that they evolved specifically for this purpose. This type of mimicry, where a harmless species mimics a harmful species, is known as Batesian mimicry. Milk snakes are not only harmless to humans, they are known for being easy to handle. For this reason, they are popularly bred and kept in captivity. At the same time, while their Batesian mimicry has helped them in the wild, it has caused problems for them with people who kill them thinking that they're dangerous. To avoid this potentially fatal mistake, people can pay attention to the shapes of a snake's blotches, according to the Savannah River Ecology Laboratory. Copperhead's blotches boast a distinct hourglass shape, while milk snakes are covered in thick, rounded markings. But milk snakes can look eerily similar to some dangerous coral snake species when it comes to these blotches. They also sometimes shake their tail, imitating a rattlesnake when in danger, throwing further confusion into the mix. Many subspecies of milk snakes overlap the venomous coral snake in range, Hayborn explained. Coral snakes also have alternating bands of color, but the patterning differs between the two snakes. Coral snakes have red and yellow bands next to one another, while the harmless milk snake has red and black bands next to each other. In areas of the world where both species exist, there are a variety of rhymes, which have been used to help people distinguish the two. For example, red on yellow kills a fellow, red on black, friend of Jack. I mean, there's so many variations of this saying, but in any case, now you know. Number 1. Water snakes. As their namesake implies, water snakes like to spend their time in and around water. Found throughout North America, they are often confused with water moccasin snakes, also called cottonmouths, who look and behave similarly but are venomous. Much like how milk snakes often resemble coral or copperhead snakes, water snakes have what's called Batesian mimicry. Unlike the water moccasin snake, who carries a dangerous bite, water snakes are non-venomous, and the two hail from entirely different families. Unfortunately, their similarity leads to many non-threatening water snakes being killed by humans. The similarity may be an evolutionary adaptation of the water snakes to avoid predation, said Bill Hayborn, the same herpetologist who spoke with Life Science about the Batesian mimicry of milk snakes. To tell water snakes apart from cottonmouths or water moccasins, a person should pay attention to a specimen's head and neck. Water moccasins tend to have blocky, heavy heads and thick, stocky bodies for their length, Hayborn told Life Science. They also tend to have a more distinct neck. Harmless water snakes, on the other hand, have a narrower, rounder head, a longer, more slender body, and a less distinctive neck. Moreover, water snakes lack heat-sensitive pits on their faces, which water moccasins do have, but above all, people are simply urged to use common sense. In Hayborn's words, if you are unsure, it is best to leave snakes alone and not risk getting them confused. Some might be friendly, some might not be. Wise words. Water snakes are otherwise pretty chill and can be friendly if they feel like it. Thanks for watching! Do you have a snake as a pet? Which one was your favorite? Let me know in the comments below, and be sure to subscribe if you are new here. See you later! Bye!